And that's how the tempered clavichord came to be, to say nothing of this Baldwin Grand. And that's why I can't play you this next overture. But actually, if we approach it pianistically in our ascent of the harmonic series, we find it somewhere around here, lying in the crack between this B flat and this A. It's one of those blue notes. Now, that blue note can be construed by the human ear as either the higher version of the note, B flat, or the lower version, A. In either case, it requires a little push up or down to be accommodated on a piano. But whichever way we construe it, it becomes our newest overtone. So we are now equipped with four different overtones, the C, plus the G, plus the E, plus that blue note, that dubious A. Or if we rearrange them in scalar order, C, E, G, and sort of A. And here we hit a real musicolinguistic universal, because now we can understand and explain that famous worldwide teasing chant. Na, 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 ollie, ollie, free. Because all it is a constellation of those first four different overtones with the tonic omitted, or rather implied. You see, this tonic C, which is the same note as the fundamental C, is heard in the mind's ear, and only the three new overtones are sung. And so these three universal notes are handed to us by nature on a silver platter. But why are they in this different order? Because that's the very order in which they appear in the harmonic series. G, E, and sort of A. And QED.